not just on the Hajjis on that day. Allah Azza wa Jalla's mercy is not limited to the grounds of Arafat on the Hajjis. Allah's mercy is unlimited, infinite, spreads, seeking anyone who is resembling Hajjis. That is why Prophet said, if you're not going for Hajj, those 10 days do not cut your nails, do not cut your hairs, and try your beards. Try to resemble the Hajjis so that when the mercy descends on the day of Arafat, that mercy also reaches you and engulfs you, envelops you. The day, the ninth day of Zulhijjah, the day of Arafah, Rasulullah said, whoever fasts on the day of Arafah, I hope, I have every hope in Allah's mercy, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the sins of the past year, that is the year that is going away, and the year, new year from the month of Muharram that is about to come upon us. I have every hope in Allah's mercy, that Allah will forgive the sins of this going away year and the sins of the coming year. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our sins. May Allah make us among those who get the maximum benefit of the coming days of Zulhijjah. A man comes to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he says, oh Prophet of Allah, my sister, she really wanted to do Hajj, but she has died. What should I do? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if your sister owed any money, owed any debt, wouldn't you pay it back after her death? The companion says, oh Prophet of Allah, of course I would pay the debt back for her. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, perform Hajj on her behalf. She will get the reward as if she performed the Hajj, and you will also get the same reward. Another person comes to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and says, oh Prophet of Allah, both my parents are old. My father is very old. He cannot perform Hajj. He cannot travel. He cannot move. And he has not done Hajj. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, you do Hajj on his behalf. Allah will reward him for Hajj, and Allah will reward you for his Hajj. Another man comes to the Prophet of Allah. Both my parents have passed away and they have not done Hajj. I wish they had done Hajj before their death. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if you pray on their behalf, if you pray Salat on their behalf, Allah will reward them for the Salat. If you give charity on their behalf, Allah will reward them for the charity. If you fast on their behalf, Allah will reward them for those fasts. Allah will reward you for the fasting you have done on their behalf. And if you do Hajj on their behalf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for their Hajj, and Allah will reward them as if they have done Hajj also. Such a merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respected listeners. Only one time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it far obligatory upon us to do Hajj in a lifetime, if you can afford it. Ibrahim Yadam Ahmadullah, one of the great pious predecessors, the heir to the throne of Afghanistan, he left everything in search and recognition of Allah, as so Allah awarded him with a high status in this world, qurb, nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was going to Hajj on his feet from Iraq, Iran area. A young man on a horse comes and says, oh Ibrahim, where are you going? He says, I'm going for Hajj. But he says, you don't have convenience. Allah says, وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنْ إِسْتَطَعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا in the Quran, that only those who have convenience transportation can afford and go to Hajj. But yet, I do not see any convenience. Listen to the answer of Ibrahim bin Adam, rahmatullah alayhi. I need to bring that into my life. All of us need to bring that in our lives. He said, I do have conveniences. Whenever any good thing comes to me, I write on the conveyance of thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever some affliction, trial comes my way, I write on the conveyance of patience. And whenever any evil thought comes to my mind, I write on the conveyance of reciting astaghfar, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, may Allah forgive me. And whenever any thought, whenever the greatness of anything comes into my heart of these worldly things, I recite on the convenience of reciting, saying Allah, Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Kullu ma'ali afan, everything is going to perish. Allah is going to remain, and His greatness is going to remain forever. The young man starts crying. I have one of the best horses in town, but I do not have any of the conveniences, spiritual conveniences you have. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is walking in the neighborhood in the night time. There were no streetlights in Medina. He sees a group of people standing and talking to each other. He asks, he couldn't see them, but he sees a group. He says, who are you? They say, mu'mineen ya Rasulullah, believers of Prophet of Allah. Rasulullah says, what is the proof you are believers? They say unanimously three things. Nasbiru inda al-bala, wa nashkuru inda al-raha, wa narzaru inda al-raha. We are patient when trials and afflictions strike us. We are thankful to Allah when good things come to us. And we are pleased with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah smiles at them and he says, key to the belief. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who do Hajj at the earliest opportunity they have not done Hajj. Living in America, we undertake 30-year mortgage payments for our loans. We have taken a loan, most of us, 30 years of loan. For Hajj, only once in a lifetime. Sure, we can take loan to do Hajj also. If you can take 30 years loan for living in America, we can take a loan for 1 year, for a few months. Little amount, go to Hajj and fulfill the obligation of Hajj. To وَتَسَبُّتُ فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ السَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Allah says, carry provision, carry, prepare, and the best of the provisions is taqwa, is the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adhaban nar. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahmah innaka antal wahhab. Ibadallah, inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan wal ita'i dhil qurba وإنها لفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفروا.